What's going on, YouTube? It's Ali Dope, and I'm checking in once again with another dope YouTube video. Yes, sir. All right, so today we're gonna create this dope ASAP Rocky moving collage from his latest video, DMB. To show you how to create a similar effect using After Effects. Now, don't just limit yourself to music videos. Think outside the box. This effects can be used for sports, once again, fashion, music, poetry, food video. Like, you got to think outside the box. Just take an effect and apply it to what you need to apply it to. Also, if you're just now joining the mob, man, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Take 2 seconds and click that red dot for the kid. Yes, sir. And go ahead and leave a like for the algorithm so you don't miss a drop. Let's hop into the computer and get started. Before we hop into the computer, I just want to show you what this effect was inspired by. As you can see, ASAP Rocky just dropped the video yesterday, 19 trending with the beautiful Rihanna. And he's always the video god, man. When I first started doing videos and stuff like that, I always looked to ASAP Rocky video for inspiration and stuff like that. He's always working with dope creatives, thinking outside the box, and I really love his creative team, man. But anyways, this effect was in the DMV video, and this is the effect that we're gonna try to go for. It comes right after this. And it's pretty much, as you can see, it's just a bunch of collages moving back and forth. Like, they're all moving. So when I seen this in the video, off the rip, I said, oh, I got to do that. I got to do a tutorial on that because that's right up my alley. Collages, now it's moving collages. Now I'm going to do the one that we're doing today is based on the Lil Baby video, but you could do this for any of your type of stuff as well, for your travel videos, things like that. This is a really, really, really dope idea, man. So many elements to it. As you can see, as it's sliding by, so many things going on. Like, he's standing on top of this thing. This is a PNG of a building or a mask. You have the car coming through, but it's still part of the video. So they probably just rotoscoped that and slid it across the main collage. You know what I'm saying? This is a PNG image right here. So is this one that's just moving up and down. This is another image that's been reversed and it just keeps looping back and forth. This is some imagery from the actual video itself, you know, the environment, the dog. As you can see, these are clips from the video as well that's moving. This was the bars. This is dope right here. This is a clip from the video and they just made a square or like a little border for it. You know what I'm saying? And multiple clips, there you go. And it's repeating, like boom, up and down, time reverse, dope. So many elements, you guys. So when I seen that, I knew I just had to create something dope for you guys as well. So let's hop into the computer once again and really hop into the program and get started, guys. Okay, so what we're gonna do first, you're gonna start your composition. Go ahead and 1920 by 1080, regular frame rate. We're gonna go 24 frames just cause I feel like that's the given frame rate. This is gonna be our main composition. So this is gonna be the main composition where the effect is gonna happen, right? And then you need to make another composition that's gonna be the actual moving collage, right? So the width right now is 1920, and we gotta multiply that by 3 because you want it a longer length. So when you add the collage and you add the effect that you have enough space to pull from. I did the math, and 1920 by 3 is 5760, and this is where we're gonna add all our actual collage moving pieces. We're gonna go back to that first comp, right? I already grabbed the music video I wanna use. I'm using the Lil Baby in a minute. It's just been on repeat for me. So I felt like I definitely need to use it. So the main concept of this effect is to grab the elements from the music video and rotoscope them. Basically, that's the base of the effect. Rotoscoping all these different types of moments in the video and making it a collage. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna select a bunch of clips from the video and put them on the timeline really quickly
So after I do that, then I'll come back and then we can hop in. We can go over the rotoscoping. So let me go ahead and select my clips and I'll be back in a second. Okay, you guys. So basically what I've done now is I've went and selected a bunch of clips from the video that I think would be cool to cut out for a collage. The next step, what you're gonna do is you wanna rotoscope the parts that you feel are the most important out of the clips that you selected. I'm gonna do a couple and then we're gonna go ahead and speed through the rest of them just so we can make this as short as possible. So here we go. If you already don't know how to rotoscope, you gotta click it. And for this one, what I wanna grab is all of them. I just wanna grab them. I wanna leave out this background. So I'm just double click on that. Click on the rotoscope brush right up here. Boom. Okay. Yeah. We have to change. This happens a lot when you're doing it. Make sure your composition is set to the same as your footage. So this is gonna be 23.96, same thing, it's already in it. So double click on it. It should be already in full mode. And we're just gonna select this empty space here and see what it selects. All right, so that's a pretty good selection. The pink is what's gonna be removed and everything else is gonna stay. So we're just gonna make sure we do that. And this background here, cool. We want to press the Alt button to subtract. We want his face in it. We want his shoulder. Cool. And then we go back to the composition. Okay, bang. We're gonna go ahead and, so after that, we're gonna go ahead and just feather it a little bit. Now you see that's disappeared. I don't want that. I want this to show. So what we're gonna do is gonna go ahead and invert it. Invert, so now you see this pink box here, it changes from over here, which is gonna delete all this, and we're just gonna invert it. So now it's gonna capture all this. We're gonna feather it just a little bit, and I wanna shift the edge so it's a little bit further out, so it gives it a little bit of spacing. We're gonna go ahead and lock that in, we're gonna freeze that. And if you go back to your main comp, as you can see, we're already starting to get that collage-y feel. So you have this collage here. Boom, go ahead and feather that up. Hide that for now, just so you don't see it. We're gonna move on to the next clip. Do the same thing for the next clip. Double click on it. See what part I want? It's just him walking. So I really just wanna rotoscope him walking. So I'm gonna grab him. I'm gonna go to a part where it's like, all right, all of him is in there. So it captures it. We're gonna go ahead and select him. Boom. And then you just wanna adjust the settings. Go ahead. If you wanna select more stuff, you can too. It's up to you. It's just what I'm trying to do. I just wanna grab baby for this one. I can grab this guy over here too. And his partner. Go ahead and scrape that all up. Get all that as much as you can. Boom. I want to delete this little area right there. I'm going to do that same thing. I'm going to go ahead and feather it a little bit. And then shift the edge out a little bit. Go ahead and freeze that as well. Go back to your composition. And as you can see, now you have... this is a pretty cool little digital background too, but... now you got... boom. There you go. That's pretty cool too. Like, boom. Now we just got him walking. It's him walking. And as you can see, it's just him walking by itself. And as you can see, that's cool, pretty cool effect as it is. So what we're gonna do is hide that as well. You want to do this for each and every clip. You wanna go ahead and select the pieces and the parts that feels like you stand out the most. And then some of them you might want to keep playing because it might just be a background. But make sure you keep in mind, you want to grab the chains, you want to grab the money, you want to grab maybe a friend, things like that. A bird, you know, for this one, where is it at? For this one, I might just crap out the table, you know? You got to be selective. Just like if you were making a collage in Photoshop, it's the same principles. So instead of masking or selecting out the piece that you want, you're rotoscoping it out. So you want to do that for each and every clip. So that's what we're going to do right now. After we rotoscope everything out, then we're going to go ahead and put the collage together. So we're going to speed through that real quick. Okay guys, so I went ahead and cut out everything, or rotoscoped everything, and now I have a good sequence. I did switch over the sequence. Now I'm editing on the actual second sequence, that 57 by 60 sequence, because that's where we actually gonna create the collage, and then we're gonna move it over to this main sequence right here. I went ahead and organized all the files from the actual still flat files to the actual cut out collages. So we're gonna go ahead and turn on all of the rotoscoped items. Okay, so basically from here, you're just gonna create the same collage, and you just wanna start adding things to the collage. So we're just gonna start moving some stuff around to figure out what the feeling is we wanna go with. So this bottega scene looks pretty cool. You know what I'm saying? Just start moving some things around. After you start moving some things around and start placing everything, I feel like that's when you'll start to figure out what you wanna do. Like, this is pretty cool right here. I'll probably keep this right there. That's good. As you can see, he's been on the plane and stuff. This third scene, this is the plane and stuff. So we can just go ahead and move over. Bang. Now, like I said, with this collage, you can always do as you feel. I'm just trying to get a good layout of what I want to do. But like I said, you gotta figure out what's gonna work for you and what you're trying to accomplish, you know? Because as you can see, ASAP Rocky's looks way different than, you know, this one. Only because, too, when you're shooting, if you shot it, or if this isn't like some footage that you just got from, you know, one of your music videos or something like that, just make sure you get a lot of clips in your scene, like different, you know, different sets of B-roll, different sets of, you know, just different vibes, you know? Move things around, move things on top of other things, you know? And as we start placing everything where it needs to be placed, then we'll start adding some other features, like some still images, stuff like that. So right now, I'm gonna go ahead and place all my pieces for my collage, and then we're gonna move from there. I will tap in when it comes to still video without the rotoscope, so you can see how it all works together. Also you guys, with these, make sure you get creative. Like this one here, you gotta flip it. You can put things on top, put things on the bottom, treat it just like if it was Photoshop. Oh yeah, quick tip. So as I'm editing the collage and putting the collage together, I want this to be about 20 seconds. When you cut out what you're trying to cut out, just make sure you duplicate everything, and make sure you make its own pre-comp or something like that, just so you have the same, for instance, this, as you can see, let me turn on some of these things. So you can see like the chain itself, the chain is here, boom, but it's short and you can't just extend the clip because it's a rotoscope. So I just duplicated it, that's it. And I just duplicate it as many times as I need to until it reaches 20, and I'll probably add a pre-comp or something like that. But yeah, that was just a quick tip, because I do want it to be about 20 seconds. My thing is always to organize all your footage into like different spaces. So as you can see, I added some guides. I kind of want it to be the plane, performing, miscellaneous. You know what I'm saying? So right now I'm trying to add all the plane footage to the first grid, so then I can just kind of work on that. As you can see, I'm kind of laying it out as I do it to see which clips work best where. And now as I'm coming to the end of like the first clips, what I'm gonna do is I do wanna mask it, because the background here, this background jewelry, You can also just create some masks. Make sure you're just using, you know, the elements, just so you can get that cool little aesthetic. That's it. Okay, and as I'm working on the collage, I ran into a little issue. So I did at the beginning, the composition is 5760, so it's 1080 by 5760, because that's the width. You can make it as long as you want. I have to extend my composition just a little bit, just so I can fit all the elements that I want into it. Like I said, you don't have to do this, but I'm doing this. I just didn't want to extend my timeline. Then you guys see it, and it's like, oh, what's up with the timeline or whatever. So yeah, I'm just gonna extend this a little bit longer just so I can fit all the things that I wanna fit in there. Okay, so as I'm winding down, I'm starting to add a little bit more effects to some of the things. So right now I have this crowd shot selected, and all I'm gonna do is toggle it back on and put lighten. So now it's kind of like merged without having to erase or mask anything. These are just quick little tips. And once again, you can always grab things like this. If it's not long enough, duplicate it, right click, time reverse. So you do that, put them together, and then that helps with some of the time things. And sometimes when the rotoscopes aren't as long enough for the clip that you want, just duplicate the layer and copy and paste them until it reaches the length that you want. Kind of finalizing right now some of the main collage right here, adding the last little bit of pieces here. Pretty much everything is laid out, locked up. If you want to see the full kind of timeline, this is kind of how it looks. These are all video clips, you guys. Every single one is a video clip. Look at that. That is awesome. I'm proud, y'all. I don't know about y'all, but this looks dope.
Yo, I ain't gonna hold you. Body that.
Wait till you finalize everything. So right now, I'm just gonna finalize some things, like massing some things and feathering some things so everything is so cohesive. And then after that, we're gonna go ahead and start cooking up. Okay, so guys, at the beginning, we made a 1080 comp, and we made a second comp with the collage. But now that I think about it, you're gonna make a composition. The first composition that you're gonna make, that you're gonna actually do all the collage effect in, is gonna be a regular 1080 by 1080. That's the size of a square. After you made your 1080 by 1080 comp, you're gonna go ahead and drop this comp 2 that we were just editing all the collage on. So let's just name it collage. So what we're gonna do now, we're gonna grab collage and drop it into that main comp, right? You're gonna hit this arrow button, go to transform, go to position, you're gonna scale it all the way over. So now it's just there, right? And pretty much what we're gonna do, since this comp is only 20 seconds before everything goes flat, We're pretty much gonna focus on that time frame. Read all that good stuff. Right, so it's only about 20 seconds, but if you wanna make it longer, you can go ahead and duplicate it. But right now we're gonna do is take this and from there to 20. So right now we're gonna make a transform layer, right? You're gonna keyframe the position right there at the beginning, go all the way to the end, pretty much the end here. And we're gonna just, we're gonna move it all the way back over to the end. You guys know exactly what I'm talking about. Just go all the way to the end. So it's like moving across the screen. I'm pretty sure it's the easier way to do this, but. So right now we have this. Cool. So now it's moving all the way across. Boom. And what I wanna do, I wanna take that same clip, duplicate it, move it over, and all I'm gonna do is reverse it. Just a right click, and then we're just gonna reverse time, reverse layer. So right there at the end, it should go right back to pushing back towards the beginning. There you go. So you got the beginning, boom, boom, boom. Then it goes back to the beginning. So that's pretty much like the collage and the movement, how you get the movement. Gotta add some kind of elements in there that make it like a collage type feeling. So I just added some photos of some textures. So I got some noise textures that I'm gonna just throw over top of the whole thing. Boom. And I'm just gonna go ahead and same thing I would in Photoshop. Go ahead and lighten it. And I'm gonna bring that opacity down just a little bit. Right there, that's cool. Go ahead and lock that one up. Then we're gonna go ahead and grab some of this. I added some dirt, I got some dirt as well, like some 8mm dirt to give it like some, you can see the little dots inside of the image. Go ahead and scale this down a little bit. Right, and then all we gotta do is, cause I need the dots to be white. So you're just gonna hit invert. Invert that, same thing. Now all we're gonna do is click lighten or screen, depends on how the dots pop up. Hey, I'm gonna go with screen on that one. Then we're just gonna go ahead and lock that layer as well. Cool. You see it, it's there, but it's not there. And that's how you can see if the dots are there. There you go. So pretty much that. Cool project. Yeah. So that's that on that. And like I said, you can get fancy. You could add some effects on top of this comp. You can go ahead and add some glow. If I wanted to add some glow to it, I got glow, you know, and it's gonna affect the whole thing. You feel me? For the final, I probably won't do the glow only because I don't really want it, but I'm just showing you guys what you can do. You can actually add transitions. You can add any type of effect, really. Just get creative. Like if I wanted to add Mr. Mercury, right? It'd be like, look, like that'd be cool. It'd still pick up all the same vibes. Like, you know, you guys gotta get creative. Think outside the box when you're creating some of these effects. I'm trying to find a cool effect that would affect everything, like flow motion. You feel me? That could be something cool. it can come in and push out, you know, something like that. If you want to do a transition when it first comes in, so I'll probably go like this and CC flow, boom. The amount I'll probably put at zero. Or shoot, I'll probably put like really strong at like 200, and then probably go a couple of clips, and I'll put it back at zero. Then I have a cool like little intro, you know? So it's all up to you what you're trying to do. But I just want to get the basic effect in there, and I don't want this tutorial to be 2 hours long, no craziness like that. But yeah, this is the main part, just to get that collage feel. I've got to play around with the settings. You can stretch them, make them longer, make them shorter, you know what I'm saying? Play around. This is the basics of the actual concept of the effect. So I just wanted to get out the basic concept. Once again, I want to emphasize that. The basic concept of the effect. And then you guys play around with your own settings. Add effects, add things like that.
Okay, guys. So that was a pretty long tutorial. So I hope that helped you in some sort of way. I hope that helped you with the basics of the effect to achieve. Once again, you can always go into Premiere and After Effects, add transitions, add some distortion, add glows, add light leaks, add other elements to bring your collage to life and to affect it. And think outside the box with this. I just want to give you the building blocks to inspire you to create something for yourself, okay? So once again, as always, keep hustling, keep creating, and most importantly, keep learning, you guys. Until next time, Ali Dope, I'm checking out. Yes, sir.